Yeah, I'm kinda jealous.
Oh, you're just jealous. Boys.
They all just jealous. Yeah, just jealous. Just jealous. Yeah.
No, jealous.
BG boys. Yeah. Oh, Snapperino. That's right, I said it. Snapperino, baby.
What's up, Adam? How's it going?
Chilling, man. I'm so glad to be doing this, man. It's been a couple of weeks here.
Yep. I think actually almost 2 months. We did that Star Wars one in it was like February.
Yeah, you know, was it? Oh man.
Yeah,
so
time like continues to fly.
If anyone missed that that episode, definitely if you want to give it a chance, if you like Star Wars, Jedi. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, definitely check that out. That was a fun episode. I had a good time in that
absolutely,
one.
Absolutely.
So but, check this out. I got my first Pfizer shot, right? And it kind of put me on my rear end like it had some others. Not terrible.
Mm-hmm.
I had like mild fever and I just kind of try to stick it out, but I just felt weak, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
Run down and sleepy. But overall, not a terrible experience. It's definitely worth getting and making sure you could avoid a worse situation. Mm-hmm. But the point is, I get to have my first beverage.
That's
my
wonderful.
First adult beverage in, I don't know, since when was the 11th? Like 2 weeks ago-ish.
I mean, hey, that's a lot. Especially during lockdown, I feel like most people were not skipping beverages for a year and change.
Right? I mean, there's not much to do, so I understand. Yeah. Folks having some extra fun in lockdown if you can. You got to keep things upbeat these days. As best we can, right?
Yeah, I had a little earlier in the week on my days off, but
so tell everybody about those gnarly mead you got.
Oh yeah, yeah. I'd found them visiting a cousin down in Savannah. They had like a little mead place in the downtown
Savannah
area,
Georgia.
The Georgia, and like a nice little like. You know, pay a fee and you get to do a bunch of tastings. And they gave me basically the contact information for these places. And in New York, they supposedly ship here, but I have not found anyone near us on Long Island that distributed. So
not on Long Island, but you could definitely find places. I'll hook you up with another place. I know you could find
mead, but this like I just knew that I tried all these kinds and I was like, I love these. I would like to get these specific ones. So I found like an online site to basically ship it to me. And I did it actually last year, right during lockdown, and got another dispatch usually like right before my birthday. So
just got to refill all the shelves just in case.
Pretty much. Yeah. They're just sitting on the bar right now. And I just, you know, have like a good one in the free. They're like small wine bottles pretty much and delicious.
Yeah. So for those who don't know, mead is, essentially honey wine.
Yeah. Yeah. Instead of grapes, they just make it with honey and some other stuff for the most part. So, yeah.
Tasty stuff. Especially if you have a sweet tooth. That stuff for me is a little sweet.
It definitely is. And I like the sweeter side of things. So,
but either way,
it was good though.
Let's talk about a little. We haven't had a podcast in a while,
right.
But we did have the opportunity to stream a little bit and have some fun with Diablo.
Yeah.
The
original
Diablo. 1996.
Obviously, the Diablo 2 Resurrection announcement was, you know, a huge deal. We are definitely excited to get it back into it. And honestly, like, talking about that kind of got me back into wanting to dive into the Diablo universe in general. And I definitely, like, when there was nothing on the PC
fresh
for a
meat.
While, yeah, we had, Diablo was like the first dungeon diving with friends that you could do back in the day. And granted, like, all the successful games coming afterwards, like, you know, really opened up the place, but I felt like bringing it back, and I asked Adam would he like to, you know, jump back in, and he agreed, thankfully, because
I agreed.
Playing by yourself is definitely a bit tougher, and honestly, we did not just go into the vanilla. We were going to originally, but I actually had been doing some research online, and they had done a mod for Beelzebub, I believe was the original mod for single player. Lots of quality of life changes. They opened up a bunch of stuff that was cut from the game. like characters and quests and that kind of thing. The what we're playing is Technurnobog, I believe is the pronunciation.
Yeah, I think we mess hard, it up every it's time. Hard, we, it's hard to pronounce.
Yeah, it's basically most of what Beelzebub gives you, but there's no questing, which is a little annoying because right. the quests were.
In other words, you can't progress along the game as you normally would. Yeah. Like yeah. we both like bought it on sale for like $10 recently, right?
Yeah, on
for
the GOG. PC. And it, even then, it wasn't just this straight up go on BattleNet. You had to like
yeah.
change router settings. Like it's a whole nightmare. Like, dude, you guys, all you had to do is make this playable easy, and like we had more steps to do.
I don't
and,
get like, it. Like, if you're gonna bring it to Windows 10,
yeah.
and you know Mac and whatnot, like how are you gonna disable yeah. the require. Multiplayer feature?
Yeah,
basically.
Exactly.
So we like we had to go like, around that is the point. And but and that's what Sean
yes,
was explaining.
They made it nice, but with this mod that they put on, it looks way better. Like I was playing that and then jumped into the mod and I was like, "Oh my god, this is like night and day." You could zoom in fully. Like there's lots of quality of life changes they made. It really they made it look a lot more like Diablo 2, which granted is that giving us
the aspect ratio,
experience?
You know, you can manipulate a little bit better
oh,
than
yeah.
you could with the original.
But like your belt, it used to be just the straight up, I think it was like 8 or 9 potion slots to start. Now it's like depending on the belt you have the stack. So Diablo 2, basically, they added like, what is it, the item sets we were finding? Like lots of cool stuff, which we'll get into during the podcast. But that's what we decided to play. However, we're also planning on talking about the original because, you know, that was kind of like what was driving the whole line to play in the first place.
It's been fun though, man. I've been enjoying going through the different levels of the mm-hmm. you know the major dungeon and whatnot, and you know we just had to tolerate dying dozens
oh,
of
yeah.
times.
I mean yeah that's a you know once you're in multiplayer all the things get harder as all the other games were, but in Diablo 1
they get
like,
you man
yeah you don't really you, there's no like skill leveling, it's all stats and items and
yeah.
maybe the spell books that you find. So you're really like just pushing through hoping for good stuff and
yeah.
you have like nothing to rely on.
Well, as like the sorceress, I was like, you know, what are you gonna do? It's just magic until you
right.
gain a high enough level
mm-hmm.
to where you can do that what is it, mana shield?
Mana shield. Yeah.
So absolutely. Once you got that, you have a chance. You're sort of like a tank mage at that point.
Yeah.
So that's where it got more fun for me anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Like before that, we took a beating.
I think like when I first played this game back in the day, actually my first experience with it was actually on the PlayStation initially. A buddy of ours had it and it was me, him, and one of his friends. They popped it in. They're like, all right, we'll get you in. And it was like my first experience of like the PlayStation duping where you give someone some items, you have them save their character, and then you like reset the game and like both characters keep their items that they saved with. Like it was a hilarious
yeah.
like nonsense duping thing where it's where that worked out. So I had like a good shield to start and was able to like go around on the controller. Then we got on the PC. When I found out that it was there and my computer could run it, because back in those days I was like the friend with like the garbage PC. That was
dude,
like
most people were that friend, you know,
I,
back
honestly,
then.
I don't know. I feel like you usually had a pretty.
What did we have in 1996? Like, assuming like a 200 and what was it? 66 megahertz PC, like those
oh,
compact Presserios. Remember those things or the Gateway computers?
Were. Yeah, man. I had no idea. I was not into computers enough to know like those things. I knew like how much hard drive space you had because you needed to know your memory. And I knew that.
RAM was always
like,
a problem.
Like you were relying on people. Like it was one of those things where like you get better at detecting like what you needed to know on a computer as time went on.
Dude.
Back then it was like asking.
It was torture back then.
Yeah.
You know, for those of you who remember playing Diablo on PC, this Diablo game, have to know about the rigors of dealing with the internet dial up. You know,
yeah. oh yeah.
Some people had 28.8 connections, and some people had the 56K, which was a big deal, fast as can be.
I don't think when this came out, the cable modem was an option yet. I don't think so, because even
no,
loading it in,
no,
like,
it was not. Maybe 97, maybe the year after.
Because even if you go into multiplayer now with it, I think it's like the TCP/IP option, which is basically like dial-up modem kind of thing.
Yeah,
you can like direct connect to someone. Which was used to be funny because back in the same time, like playing with like John, I would be in a game, and I usually, after a while, we just always made multiplayer games because usually you wanted to jump in with someone at one point. So I'd be playing, it would be like a Saturday morning, like early, I woke up, the house is sleeping, and I'd be on the computer playing. And we actually had the dedicated
the first of the next
line.
8 hours of
we had like
Diablo sitting.
The dedicated modem line you had in the house, like for internet, like not your house phone.
Yeah,
like that was huge for us because I was like one of those people that you always saw the memes of like get off the phone on the internet.
Yeah, yeah.
So that thing,
I gotta call mom. Come on.
I'm like, it had a phone though, so you knew a call was coming through. And I remember I'd hear the phone ring, and I'd be like, oh. And I'd have to, like, it was a weird thing where I had to pick up the phone for the computer to receive the signal. But I knew that John was probably trying me just on chance that I was in Diablo. And sure enough, I'd pick up the phone and I'd see, like, he popped in the game.
Oh, so my
was, like,
God.
The two of us on it, like, a Saturday morning. Wow. Like, hey, you want to go, you know, dive into this dungeon?
See, these are memories. I always compliment Sean's ability to remember all these childhood events that are just gone in my mind until he brings them up. Then all of a sudden I'm like, oh my God, yes, I do remember this. But I'm never the guy to be like, oh, remember in fourth grade when we went to this place on that Saturday? And I'm just not me, you know?
Yeah, something has to like spark it, I guess, right? Get the memory
for sure
going. Like, wait a minute, this reminds me of a time. But you know, I will say, like, as much fun as I'm remembering right now, I would like to talk about why we're not playing the original specifically. There was definitely some downsides to the original, and granted, it was like the first of its kind, so you kind of just dealt with it. But just like weird things, like inventory management was very difficult. You had a set amount of slots plus what you could wear, and you didn't have any more. There was no stash. Like Diablo 2 creating the stash was like tremendous. So,
That was huge.
Yeah, you had to deal with it. And like even money, it wasn't like you had money just on your character. It was a stack, and they stacked up to $5,000 at most. And then you'd have to have another square of your inventory taking up.
I thought it was 50,000.
No, in the original, it was 5,000. So like to have a lot of money, you needed like a lot of inventory space taken up by money.
Yeah, so, that's crazy.
Yeah. So when you were playing with people, a lot of the times you would just make a game. Because like the game would save if you were like in single player. So you could just throw stuff on the floor in town and that would be fine. But if you're playing multiplayer, you have to like get rid of some of your inventory. So you kind of would need to like put your stuff. Like I remember in town, you'd have to like dump stuff like in areas not in the main beaten path. So if someone walked around town, they'd find your stuff and like steal it. But you used to be like on the side, like go to like the corner of the map and just drop a few things and then just go up to join everybody. So that when you were done playing with everyone, you could go pick your stuff up and leave.
Wasn't there a similar problem in UO where you couldn't stack like a certain amount of money? So you had to have multiple stacks, but it had weight to it. So that was like a whole being able to get things in your bank in different boxes. So
before they
changed
started making
it.
The what was it, the banknotes you started getting where it was like paper?
Checks, like, I guess, technically.
Yes. So before that happened, you literally needed to have money, and if you got overloaded, your money would like drop to the floor. It was like,
oh, that was the best. Do you remember?
Yeah, there was a lot of scamming stuff going on.
Oh, those poor victims of digital scam, even though it doesn't cost anybody anything other than grief.
I mean, it's your time.
And your digital gold.
Yeah.
No! Not my digigold.
You owe monies.
Do you remember we used to stand outside like the digital houses? And wait for people to come home and teleport in the house or just run in the house real quick, kill them, and take the key?
Yep. Hiding was like the best skill in that game. I still think it was. Like one of
the top man.
Skills. Once you were a mage, you could cast hiding, I guess.
It was better when it was just hiding and not like, what is it called? Like the stealth? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I know what you mean. Yeah. I mean, they were both good, but like. The hiding was great, though. I always made a character. Like I think most of my characters had hiding.
When your skill was 100, you just press the button and he hides? Yep. That's what's up.
In the shadows.
Well, yeah. These are UO days, which weren't too far removed, honestly, from these days.
No, they were probably around the same
time. UO was right after this, was it not, I guess?
Or maybe even
simultaneously,
right before,
even? Or?
Yeah. It's kind of hard to tell. This is pretty... It might have been right after, but I was still playing this during those times also. So...
I don't know. I felt like that was 97, 98 for UO.
Yeah, I mean,
this was 96, so it was really the same realm
of. Diablo 2 wasn't until like, I don't know, 2000, maybe?
No, I think that was 98, dude.
We were freshmen, you think?
I'm telling you, yes.
I don't know. Oh, man. I thought
because I used to stop by Dave's house like early in the morning.
Oh, you're right. Maybe it was. Yeah, maybe.
You remember that when Diablo 2 came out? He was in love. That,
oh, dude, absolutely.
That game was absolutely. Boo.
We'll have him on to talk about that.
For sure. Oh, man. I'm sure the stories he could tell for that game.
Yep. But I digress. The what else do we have? Oh, the stat caps. That was a weird thing with Diablo 1. That was like, I mean, I'm not used to it, I guess, in a lot of things. Like, UO, I guess you had 100, whereas like Diablo 2, there was no stat. You could just put points into whatever you wanted.
Yeah.
If you wanted to make a sorceress with all strength, like, I guess, go for it. It's stupid, but do it. No one's going to stop you. But this, like, each character, it wasn't even like a set. Like, each character had their own stuff, which I guess makes sense because, like, if you're a wizard studying magic things, you're not like pumping iron, probably.
Yeah.
So having a wizard being able to get like jacked strength is ridiculous. So I see where they were going for it.
It turns into like short range and middle range to long range, right? So if you're like the paladin, you're going to be short range, obviously. It's going to be.
I guess. But if, but as far as like the first Diablo, even the stats, like, so your magic came from like your spell pool, basically. Your mana was directly from magic. Vitality was your health. Strength was both damage and also the minimum requirement to wear stuff, which Diablo 2 kept. And dex was like armor class to hit, which were tremendous. So like if you're a warrior, having like, I think like it was like 65 or something was your max dex. So like you hit that kind of early because otherwise you're whiffing. To him, like in the beginning when we were playing, it was like just whiffing the whole time. Like, no, it's terrible.
Yeah, but once weird. He starts hitting, it becomes ridiculous. You really get those shots in quickly.
I mean, you need to, though, like, just because all the shots,
but like the swing rate is so ridiculous, you know, if you think about it.
It
he's like
be, yeah.
Like, yeah. It's like rabbit punches. I will destroy.
Because some people walk around with like the heavy two-handed axe, and you're just like,
yeah,
using those things. But
isn't it amazing how sound effects give things weight?
Oh,
like if you swing like a halberd or like a mace, you hear, you know, as opposed to the sword sound. So it's funny how that adds an element. Like, I don't know. Mm-hmm. To me, that stuff fascinates me. How they integrate sound. You know, and Blizzard in particular, back in the day, all their games would be so smooth. That's the only thing I do like when I'm dragged into playing Fortnite with my son and he wants somebody to play with, I'll jump on with him. It's one thing I will say about that game, graphically and control-wise, it is so smooth that just like, it's like butter. It's perfect. So that's kind of how, you know, Blizzard made their games. Everything was pretty much smooth as can be. You knew you were going to get a polished product.
Smooth like eggs.
Yeah, so, and Diablo was no exception.
I think Blizzard did not make this. I think it was another company, and then they got bought by Blizzard and became like Blizzard North, I think was how this went down.
Yeah, isn't there so like a Blizzard Activision or something? I don't even know who owns them now.
Yeah.
They were definitely purchased like at least one or two times over.
Mm-hmm. You know what was actually very interesting with this game, too, at least for the original? I'm pretty sure the version we're playing, they took away a lot of the nonsense with it, maybe kept some things. But they had a lot of troll items and shrines, which, granted, we definitely found a few troll items like that, the cudgel of uselessness.
Yes.
That had, like, zero attack. Like, hilarious.
Yeah, they throw in, like gag weapons.
Yeah, thank you for drop. Like,
or armor that makes you worse.
And here's, yeah. Like, thank
minus
you
points.
But the shrines used to be crazy. Like, I remember, like, I had a marble notebook next to the computer. I remember there was only two games I ever kept, like, a marble notebook for. One was Carmen Sandiego.
Gotta have it.
Flags. Dude, you need it for the flags. Like, she went to a country with a red, black, and white flag. And it's like,
I'm not gonna remember.
I would never remember that. I'm sure there's kids that were geniuses that probably went on that PBS show and won.
There you go. But training all year.
I needed, and I had.
Remember that PBS show?
Oh, dude, absolutely. Rockapella.
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? And they try to make it this hip thing for kids, and it was
absolutely.
What is this?
I mean, I watched it. I watched it every day after school. Absolutely. I was.
Oh my god! Right, getting down at your house. Yeah, where is this lady?
But the shrines had weird titles, so you had no idea. Like, it would just be like glimmering shrine. I'm like, what the hell is this? And you have to like look for what it is. And the only reason you need to do that, because they had things that would like actually like could ruin your character a little bit, which is like completely crazy that they would throw this in. But I guess it's a game, so you deal. Like some weren't so bad. Like for example, they had the Enchanted Shrine. I remember
the Enchanted Shrine.
Plus one to all your spells that you have. Awesome. One spell.
Plus one to all?
All spells. So whatever whatever books you read, but one random spell would lose 2 levels.
Oh.
So it could be good. Could be awful for if it's your main magic spell.
Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like it.
That's what I'm saying. So it's like, are you taking that risk? They had ones that, what do you call it? The Fountain of Tears. Minus one random attribute, and you get plus one to all the others. Sounds okay.
Not terrible, yeah.
A level up, but if you capped one of your skills, and like let's say I cap my dex on my warrior, and I get that, and I minus one from like my
dex,
magic,
bro.
I'm gonna only get my strength vitality upgraded. The dex isn't gonna get anything because it's capped. So depending on where you are in your stat allocation, it could be good or bad. But that was just one of the things we just.
That's a hell of a thing to ask a man. Where are you at in your stat allocation?
Yeah. Where's your status?
What are your stats, bro?
What do you mean? What are you getting at here?
Give me your stats.
Nope. Your status, situation, allocation,
oh my God.
Concentration.
My goodness. Dude,
so
I don't know.
Those are the big downsides, I think, to the original. They did away with a lot of some things. Like they had like... I remember they had one weird enemy that you'd find in like the not even that late in the game. They looked like zombie characters, but they were like kind of neon glowy yellow. I can't remember what the hell their names were. And they would whiff on you all the time. But if they hit you, you lose your like a one from your max health pool, like just gone permanently.
Permanently?
Permanently.
How do you know it's permanently?
I had no idea, because I read it online later, years later, having not known that I may have been hit and losing health.
To get into the internet
character.
Truths.
Yeah. And it was just like Black Plague, I think they were called or something. It was like ridiculous. Where it's like, okay, so don't even go near them unless you're like an archer or a mage. So a warrior, you're just like risking these guys like hitting you like once in, it's like a one out of like, I don't know, 10 to hit you.
So what level did we get to? We played what, 3-4 times?
Yeah, I think, I mean, and
in
know,
the past
like
couple
a
of weeks?
3-hour session, like a 2-hour session, like a 1.5. So. We put some time.
So I lost count of like what level staircase we got to. It was in the teens or 20s. How high does it go?
I mean, it's different. Because it's the, what do you call it? You're in the main dungeon of the cathedral, and then it's the catacombs, the caves, and then I think hell. I think it's four different.
Did we areas. Did we get to hell or no?
I think we may have.
Did we get to HE double hockey sticks?
Yeah, we may have just gotten there, or we were right about to get there. It's one or the other, because we were getting destroyed by like the succubuses and those other random creatures. The only thing we didn't run into yet, which I'm not sure if it's just later in hell, are like there's like these teleporty guys that are like the freaking worst. They're fine for wizards, but this is one of those things where I was telling you, like, I'm playing a warrior and Adam is playing the wizard character.
Yeah.
And there is definitely a point where the wizard just takes off and is like much better, but I wanted to go to my roots of my first character. But for sure, the best character I ever made was the wizard, because you need to. Guardian is the best.
Yeah, well, you got to have one in the party, right?
Yeah. Well, you don't like need to. It's just silly to not. Like, I feel like I've seen, like, I remember John's brother Bob had an amazing war. He had like the best stuff, and he could like kill Diablo in like one or two shots, like two swings of his axe. It was insane.
Right.
But that was like, you know, he like really pushed that character to the max to be able to do that. Whereas like the wizard, you'd go in and like you find like a staff of apocalypse. You just go in, you pump that a few times, right, and it just dies. It's like ridiculous. But getting a bunch of guardians,
the staff of apocalypse,
hiding around while you're getting shot with things, like that was the best.
I guess that's always been a Diablo staple, right? Like all these elaborate names to all these different weapons and pieces of armor pick up.
Oh yeah. All the different
and the different names of the different demons and awful creatures that come after you that you endlessly mow through. But
and like it's definitely interesting some of the AI they even had for like an old game like this. Like some of these guys, like, you know, the goblin creatures that'll like run away after one of the guys dies. Like just crazy where it's like, what are you doing? And like the succubus would just be like kiting you. She just like runs away while you're getting shot by everyone else. Like ridiculous. You weren't running after much people, you were just shooting spells at them. I'm chasing them, like Come here.
What was that charge bolt, right? I was using?
Yes.
Where you just shoot out little like 1 foot charges of lightning and eventually it creeps towards the enemies and starts mowing them down.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what level we got to, but there was a point where we got to where we were just getting obliterated. And remember, we had to pour back to and from town over and over.
I believe in the catacombs we were getting destroyed when it was just the two of us at first. That one point,
in the catacombs,
we met those stupid like dog creatures that spit acid at you. Like we got like destroyed at one point. We just did not have
in the murky catacombs.
We had to like really work our way to get through it. And then we had that rando in our last session join us, gave us like a crazy amount of money,
a million apiece.
Yeah,
like, he hooked it up.
Not exaggerating, a million apiece, and it. With this thing,
it's like the reverse of stream sniping.
Yeah,
he just hooked it up instead of grief dust, you know.
Yep, and he gave me like his old axe, so I had like this crazy axe to eventually use, and I was like, "This is great." So, but like again, three people now, it's that much harder, and we just got to a point where like we had the dudes, those like big hulking creatures casting inferno at us.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Once it got to that point, it was just mowing us.
Oh yeah.
Well, the flames and anguish.
We eventually did it, but like, yeah, we were like blowing through like tons, like basically inventory's worth of potions to like
over and over. Over and over. Good thing we got all that gold to just buy the endless supply.
We would have been able to do it. No question. We would have been out of gold and just been like, well, I guess that's it. Oh, actually, that is one other thing I did not mention. They fixed, not even like, remember Diablo 2 was if you died, you had to go get your corpse? So this game, you just restart in town with all your stuff. In the original Diablo, if you got killed, but not from a player, if a player killed you, you just drop their ear. But if you got killed by a monster, you would drop everything you had equipped onto the ground.
Like all
your ear just hit the ground. So you would have to go in naked.
Yeah.
And oh my God, that was brutal. Oh my God. I remember literally John calling me one morning because
I'm not giving up my stuff, man.
He died from something in like, I think it was like the caves. And he's like, dude, like, I cannot get my body. Can you join the game and help me like fight this stuff off?
Can you join my game and please help me, please?
I had to go in and I think even I died at some point. Like I was able to get them away from his body a bit. And then he had to like teleport through hell and work his way up the staircases to like get back to where we were and like got it that way. Like I lured them away.
See, that's a good friend. Yes, I will log on to your online internet game and I will save your internet gold.
Not even his gold.
The items. Yeah, no, I know. Oh, I know.
The rings that give you plus all the stats, like like a few to all stats. Like, yep, I can't lose this.
Well,
oh man.
But alternatively thinking, if you lose all that stuff, maybe you deserve losing all that stuff if you're going to bring it out to the dungeon of despair.
I guess. As a wizard, I feel like you have a much better chance of doing it than a warrior. Like, if a warrior dropped all their stuff, you literally have nothing to use anymore. Like, your only attack is your big weapon, and it's on the floor now.
Oh, no.
Like, you could have no gear, but still, like, your spells or whatever you read books up to, and you could just fire from a distance. But, oh, my God. That's great.
Good times, man.
Yeah.
Good times.
Speaking of, I remember like really getting into while we were playing, the music started blasting up throughout the game.
Yeah.
Like we hit a groove at one point when we were in
classics.
I think it was the caves or the catacombs. And like you just got like those drums pumping.
Oh, yeah. We got them.
Oh, my God. It was very cool. Like,
and the spooky, like, ghoul sounds.
Oh, yeah. But like once
you
I,
are
like,
screwed,
one I know was like
the
really
butcher is coming. Fresh meat.
Fresh meat
for the grinder. Yeah,
that's the one thing that like we are missing with this is not having those random quests come up where you're, you know, like that. We don't even have the bloody dude outside of the cathedral anymore. Given the quest where it's like, oh, we were lied. Lazarus tricked us.
Yeah.
This poor bleeding death clumps outside. Everyone's like, everyone's in town like not caring. Like, oh, well, sucks to be him.
Them's the breaks. I have a job.
I'm just an old man. I can't grab people. Maybe
I sit by the well and ID items. For free, no less.
No, it's not free.
He charges you, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. He does charge
that
you.
That son bitch to charges you.
I think Diablo 2 is free. They just were like, ah. Just
we'll give him. They're going to ID it anyway. It's digital money and it doesn't go to anyone's real pocket. So
I did like when you got different quests in the original, when you went back to town, like every townsfolk had like a little bit to talk about, like it was like extra dialogue. So it kind of, it did make it seem very like in and like it was cool that you were like with these few cast of characters, and there was a lot to it. They didn't really like, you got a little bit as the game went on, but I remember being like very crazy, like when you really like thought about it, like they were like at a blockade almost where you're like underneath this cathedral that literally goes down to like hell, which I don't even know if it's technically hell.
It's heck, man. You go into H-E double hockey sticks is what it is.
So, like you go into hell in Diablo 2 and that's like the Arcane Sanctuary and all that stuff. So yep. I don't know what they retconned this hell to end up being, but like you have all these things that could easily rise up out of the cathedral and like overtake this town, and they kind of just don't. And they kind of like are waiting for your characters to go in to like eventually kill Diablo. But like no one can leave. Because anyone that tries leaving, like
nobody leaves.
Like, Dark Riders, like killing them and stuff like that, like very.
Now
like,
you just can't leave.
Stuff. Like I don't know. I always thought that was like a very like very dark like thing you don't really think about.
Well, yeah, it's Diablo, man.
But like,
you're going into a living hell.
But in the other games, like the towns had like a normal town. There just happened to be monsters outside. This was like Tristram is just like stuck. And no one can get in or out except for a few characters that just come in to like, you know, destroy the town, like destroy the catacombs and stuff. And like the innkeeper happens to like have a stock of food so that everyone else isn't starving because they can't like have.
Oh, he's the innkeeper.
Like, but like, think about that though. Like, it's like almost being under siege. It's a very like very strange thing with this, and they just it kind of the way the
kind of like Steven Seagal.
But,
wow, dating myself.
Yeah, I was going to say, Under Siege.
It was a blockbuster night back then.
Tommy Lee Jones. And,
Under Siege 2. That's the best one. That's the one where he's on the train, right?
Yeah.
And he but just fights his way through all the cars and, you know.
But Gary Busey and Dreg. You don't remember that? That was.
Oh, my God. That's right.
In the first one?
Oh, my God. Yes. What was that movie where the lady comes out of a cake?
I don't know. There's a lot. I feel
like. And he's like a Navy SEAL or something in that one. Was that Under Siege, the first one?
Maybe. Yeah, that might have been.
Isn't that it?
The Gary Busey. I don't remember if he came out of a cake though. I don't quite remember.
Well, he doesn't come out of the cake. There's a nice lady that comes out of the cake.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It was like someone's birthday or something on the ship.
Maybe. Yeah, that was probably what it was then. Yeah. But I know that he was in drag, and then they start murdering everybody.
Take over. Ruthless Steven Seagal. I wonder with like all these 80s movies, like the tally of either meaningless or important kills across all these different movies.
Oh,
neck snapped.
like
the random henchman.
Hot Shots Part Deux had that whole thing.
Part
Deux. Like shooting all the people and they're like, more kills.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
More kills and terminate. High score.
Yeah. Well, it gets to that point, right? Like Commando. How ridiculous is that movie?
Yeah, Commando is amazing. That's still like.
Oh, it's fantastic. Honestly, it's so bad, it's the best.
It really is. Hot Shots Part Deux, though, he literally grabs a handful of bullets from a bin, throws them, and they'll get like shot.
Yeah. Of course.
That was my favorite. Like, this is how you spoof action films right here. Charlie
yeah, they did it right back in the day, like between the airplane movies and like that slapstick kind of style.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
They don't make them like that anymore. I think they should. They got to bring those back somehow.
I don't know. They tried. Like, think of like the last couple, like superhero movie, date movie, like all these movies are garbage. You know, like they just not what they were.
You need a Leslie Nielsen, man. You need like one of these guys that can be totally serious and do goofy stuff.
The scary movies were like probably the best.
Those were great. Especially the first. That was obscene. But
yeah, that's oh well.
Yeah, how do we get here? I said Blockbuster Night and all of a sudden we're talking about
Under Siege.
Arnold Schwarzenegger movies and
Under Siege from the Town.
That's Under Siege. That's right.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It was cool looking back also after playing like Diablo 3 and stuff, where like Adria the Witch has such like a big role.
Yeah.
Kind of like uncovered that like here, that's the chick that's
they bring her back. It's awesome.
Yeah. And like they like retcon a lot of like the even the three, because it's the warrior, the wizard, and the rogue are your three playable characters in Diablo 1. And they even like retcon them into being like actual people. Like the warrior is Aiden, I think is his real name.
Mm.
And he's supposed to be King Leoric's other son.
And, King Leoric.
And he's the character that like they officially make at the end of the game of Diablo when you one like the main character is supposed to shove the Diablo crystal into their forehead, because that's a good idea. Like, you know, sure, I'll contain it.
We got to figure out how to mod this game and then just redo the voiceovers. King Leoric's crown, dude. Make it all goofy.
I mean, I think you'd be better off just making like a mini series than sticking that in the game.
That's actually a good idea. Let's do it. The Diablo miniseries.
I'm
the Horadric Cube.
But he's the Dark Wanderer, dude. The whole Diablo 2 story of always to the east.
Yeah.
The warrior. And they made the wizard was, I think his real name is supposed to be like Jazrith. And he ends up being the summoner in Diablo 2. When you go to the very end at the palace, you go into the weird arcane sanctuary and there's that one dude before you go to fight the last boss.
Yeah.
Remember that like weird area and you fight the summoner guy? He has like the weird hat and stuff. That's the wizard. That's the dude you're playing as right now in Diablo. That is who that is.
Yeah, that's wild.
Yeah. And the rogue becomes Bloodraven from Diablo 2.
Oh.
She, after beating this game, becomes like, I guess they're all changed and I guess she gets darker. Ondariel ends up corrupting her and the whole Sisterhood of the Cyclist Eye, which is why all those like random.
How dare he? Hondariel. All,
like, the original like concept of like those characters are like really crazy. Like, they're all like naked with like veins and stuff coming through them. Like that's what.
Dude, that was kind of like spooky, you know, stuff back in the day.
Absolutely, absolutely.
But those now, cinematics were like so boss because like it was just like an innovative thing to really have a good cinematic.
Oh, yeah,
in a game too.
I was down. We were like so ready when that came. When like when Diablo 2 came out, like, which we'll definitely hash into that. But even like the ones in this game, like they have like the whole like beginning sequence where like the guy's walking through the town, like the crow pecks out the corpse's eyeball and stuff. Like gruesome shit going on.
Gruesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty gnarly.
I do like the how this game though, like you're always chasing, like it's like Leoric getting what is it? He gets like basically ruined by Lazarus, his wizard, I guess like vizier or whatever you want to call it.
I need a wizard. This is my boy, the wizard.
Yeah,
but he takes care of business for me.
Yeah, come go see my wizard, please. I can't handle
it. It's like see my attorney. Go see my wizard.
Wizard will take care of it. It's fine.
He has my gold pieces. Don't worry.
Stuff to do, like counting money and having my feet up and being fanned.
It's hot in hell. Oh god.
I do find it weird that like you fight Leoric in this as the Skeleton King, and then in Diablo 3, like they're like, all right, you know what? We really like that guy. You're gonna fight him again. Here he is. I mean, it was a cool fight again, but it was still like, why are you back?
Yeah,
you were already taken care of.
Wow, that's the thing. As the story re-unfolds, you know, this is what happens.
Yep. Like, nope, we brought him back.
The gates of hell are reopened. Yeah. Smashing down, and the third one, smashing down heaven's gates and destroy, you know, that whole thing. Mm-hmm. It's like, where do you go from there? So,
I mean,
looking forward, you saw the trailer to Diablo 4, yeah?
Oh, of course. Yep.
Okay.
With like that druid looking or barbarian.
Yes, and they're in some tomb or something. What, I don't even remember. Did it have to do with the black crystal thing? The soul crystal?
Well, it was Lilith, right? That's what they're trying to get.
And like a wisp came by and basically took this thing back. And then he says, don't worry, you know, the Nephilim will get you or whoever, you know. Mm. But it looks interesting. When do you think this is coming out? Because the Diablo 2 remaster is coming out in 2021. There's no way they're releasing 4 anywhere close to it.
4 is its own project. These guys, I think, what are they?
It definitely is. But do you think they would release Diablo 4 right after the 2 remaster?
Because this is like really a game for people that want to play it and want something to do. Because they made that phone game, which, like, I don't know. I guess people like it. It looks like garbage.
But it doesn't, from a business perspective, it doesn't make sense to release Diablo 2 remastered because you want people to play that. You know what I mean? And sure, like it.
But this is a game that already exists that people were fans of that are, in fact, still playing it now. Like, if you go online right now, like, there are seasons of Diablo 2 that are out and stuff like that of people doing their things, just like there's the seasons in Diablo 3.
They're updating seasons on Battle.net?
I don't know how it's being done, because, again, I'm not playing.
I know 3 they're doing it still.
Yeah, but on 2 also. Like, right now. Like,
really? I didn't know that.
But I don't know if it's Blizzard doing it or if it's, like, a mod thing doing it. I believe it might be. It's possibly just a mod site of, like, a community. So there's people playing it. So, like,
a mod site
is, I don't, like I said, I'm not, I don't know anything about that. I just know that I see people.
What do you know, Sean? What do you know? Tell me what you know about Diablo.
I didn't want to jump on because now that they announced the resurrection, I'm just looking forward to playing that.
Dude, I've seen gameplay of the alpha and it looks so clean. It looks so dope. Yeah. It looks so nice.
And you could switch back and forth to the original too if you want, right? Like, I'm pretty sure on a push.
Well, I believe that's accurate. I know StarCraft, when they did the remaster of StarCraft, the original StarCraft, you could flip back and forth to the old graphics.
I doing it, and it was very trippy. Like, even like in like Loot Galane, they were like over by like the docks when you're going in like the sewers. They were like standing there. To seeing like the modern graphics to like the original, like it was crazy, like how the waves
are
almost non-existent to like looking like a holy like sculpted world on the like very cool.
It looks great, man. It looks absolutely fantastic. I can't wait to play it. When do you think it's gonna release? If you were to guess, holiday season, 2021.
No. For this, I think it's gonna be either end of summer or during summer or maybe quarter 3. I don't think it's going to wait till the holidays.
Quarter 3. So July 26th, say.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. I think summer or end of summer, like, is what I'm guessing. Because, I think beta is coming out real soon. I feel like they're going to have that, make whatever tweaks, and then, up, there you go.
Did they mention something about the beta?
No. They have not. I've seen people that they've already been taking questions and stuff about, like, what people were looking forward to. And I believe they're going to release the beta, I guess, with some changes. And then maybe do like one more final question.
That's a brilliant thing to do with a game too, to do an alpha and a beta, because you can get feedback from people who are playing the game for hours and are like, yo, this sucks because X, you know what I mean? So they get that quick feedback, and on this, I'm sure they can't change everything, but on the stuff that's an easy fix, they just go back and fix it.
True.
And it's just nice to have a nice polished product.
It's not like this is a game from scratch, because this was something that they were building off of. Like, it's basically most of Diablo 2 with some fixes. So it's not like everything that was wrong.
The whole lighting is completely different, though.
Oh, yeah. It's great. I love it. It looks darker. It looks awesome.
Dark as can be, but, like, the light feels like candlelight. You know what I mean? Like, the whole aura of it looks... I can't wait. It looks amazing.
Like, is like a cartoony, wacky thing, which is enjoyable, but it's like its own thing. Diablo 2 was very good, but Diablo 1, I feel like, was definitely the darker tone, like, of things. Like, everything
for sure
was just gloomy.
I agree with that.
The tone was just like, you were definitely And again, like with also the slow speed that you had of like walking around in Diablo 1, it was a true dungeon crawl. Like you weren't running around. Like Diablo 2 running was very awesome for us having not wanting to like walk around slowly, but it became more of a you run after monsters and you're just blowing through creatures. Whereas in Diablo 1, you're kind of like creeping up and like fighting stuff as it came.
Yeah.
It created a completely different like tone of like disaster. Because even like if you were trying to get away, you couldn't just like pop out. I mean, granted, the wizard can teleport, I guess, if you were good. But like you were like walking away from someone and they're like kind of walking after you. And it's like, Jesus.
Yeah. My gripe with 3, it's something I like, but it's something I feel like they beat over the head too much, which was like when you walk around and you can click on a book that pops out. And it starts telling, gives you the audio and the lore behind the different things.
In all these games, that was like my favorite thing.
I love it. But in 3, for some reason, like they would drop a book right by like a boss that you just beat. So you're listening to the boss, the main story. Aww. And then you're, if you hit the book before, you sort of, it switches to the book.
Yeah, it overlaps. Yeah.
And it was just the timing, I felt like, of certain ones. In my experience, anyway, was
I completely understand
bizarre. It didn't make sense. I love as you walk along the dungeons and you click them and you hear a story. I like that. It's an awesome element to the game. But yeah, exactly. You hear, the scribbles. Everything's a journal entry.
Very, very cool. And like I feel like they kept it in both Diablo 1 and Diablo 2. Some of those tomes were like the same dude, the same like
fucking,
like, oh man, so good. And like you always got like a piece, and that's what I did like about each game coming out, was like they, like even the third one, like Red Osmodan was that like crazy looking
Osmodan. Yeah,
like they, it was cool, like you, because we were reading about or hearing about him through lore in the first game, and now like they're finally bringing him out. Like I always liked that each game almost like gives you like another piece, like you were hearing about these things and then there they are.
I felt like the visuals in Diablo 3 were kind of funny, though.
Oh,
like,
sure.
These puffed up, big, like, you know, Asmodan, or, you know, a bunch of these guys are ridiculous looking.
They should be. Like, these things are like devils kind of thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, the demons and whatnot.
Like, they were even, like, even Diablo 1 was,
and
like...
And they're always, like, they're always made of molten lava, and you know?
Yeah.
Like, when they open their mouths, it's just pure flames. Mm. Oh, man.
I do think, I think like the way that they set up, at least like retcon style with like having what you've like learned about in 2, I think more so in 3, they kind of expanded on a lot too, was like Diablo 1, they had a whole issue with that Diablo was like trapped in the crystal and Lazarus was trying to bring him back. They were trying to have giving him like a new like host, and Leoric, I think, just went like batshit crazy, so they couldn't use him. That was like the whole thing.
Leoric went batshit crazy. We can't use him.
So, they tried using his son, Albrecht, but I guess because he's a child, it wasn't a good enough host body. So, like, when you fight him, it's the kid possessed by Diablo.
Yes.
So, I guess, like, that's why his form being humanoid, like, would make sense, where it's, like, it's not his true form, so it's okay. And I feel like the way that they, the way I've heard people talk about this was very unique in the sense that, like I was talking about before, how it's, like, a town under siege, how, like, they could have easily overrun this place, but they didn't.
Oh, yeah.
They, like, they almost were waiting for someone.
They lure people down.
But they wanted someone. They didn't want to just give it away to someone. They wanted like the proper, like a warrior type person that was strong enough to fight things. So you're getting like
the predator mentality. Fight. Like you want to hunt.
You're getting like
warriors only.
Not even a warriors only. Like you're getting like the this is a worthy host body. He's able to fight his way down. Like he'll be able to contain me enough where I can, you know, use him to become myself. And the same thing. Like, so they almost, like, it was almost a big trap, basically, to get you down to like kill him and then be like, well, I guess I got to stick this in my head now, because what are the odds that that's going to be his thought?
What are the odds?
That's what he does.
Never tell me those odds. Oh, God.
I always like, I repeated this. It was always like, that's the plan. That's all you had. We're going to shove this into my head.
I think
cool
the idea was to make it like a, you know, a childhood nightmare type situation.
Yeah.
Where it touches you to your roots, because it's like, you know.
And then
this happened to me when I was 4.
Yep.
Oh,
Adrian's going to bang him because she just wants to bang Diablo. That's
what she's got to do.
That's what happens. That is the story. You think I'm lying?
These are facts.
Yep, you're gonna. We're gonna bone, and we're gonna make you your better vessel.
Yes.
How crazy is that?
It's pretty crazy.
Weird, far-thinking things. Like, yep, this like, is what we're gonna
on
do.
On some Satan spawn level.
Yeah. That's it. We're gonna. Yeah. Antichrist.
Oh my god.
Just wait for that one.
Man, we're in the Diablo weeds here, my God.
Yeah.
Whew. It's a good game, though, man. Really enjoyable stuff. Very nostalgic.
It's nice with this mod, though, the turning up the town walk speed.
Oh, like, it's so much better.
As much as I like do enjoy when you're
It looks funny because they're like, you know, fast motion.
But it's necessary.
It's totally worth it, yeah. It
would really lengthen your time, like walking, especially walking to Adrian.
In the dungeons, it goes back to normal speed.
Right, which is fine. I like that.
That's what it should be, yeah.
Slow it down and keep. But in town, like, I just want to get to where I need to go, buy my.
Buy your potions, sell your items, repair your stuff.
Oh my God. Especially as a wizard, you'd have to, like, heal, ID, go to Griswold, sell stuff, then walk all the way to Adria and this thing, and then walk all the way back to your town. So bad. Oh my God. Oh, dude, they added the waypoints.
Yes.
What a wonderful thing that did not exist in the original.
Very convenient.
Yep. You had just those little waypoints that like went back to town, but this is like legit waypoints.
And they placed them well too, like in nice spots. Not too close to the stairs and whatnot. You have to actually go find them.
I feel like the dungeons are still randomized as they usually are, but either way, just having them is just a nice.
Are those dungeons really randomized?
I'm pretty sure they're all random.
Maybe the spawns of the characters.
Well, where the staircases are, I don't think they're in the same spot.
You don't think so?
No, I'm pretty sure they're random. Pretty sure this was like one of them. That's why.
I don't recall that.
Like, think about that. If it was the same, when you left my game, you would have your map filled in. Like, remember, you got booted out a few times? Like, you would still
You never have the map filled in. I think once you die, your map craps out.
Once you leave the game, when you're in the game, whatever you have, even if you die, your map's still what you had.
Oh, I guess. But like, if you can't leave the game and come back and then have your map be
right. But I'm saying, if it was like, if you had already explored this in your game and you were up to the caves, like those other maps should have been filled in by, you know, if it was the same. So I think the only things that don't change are like the instance ones. Like, I don't think Leoric's tomb is any different. I'm pretty sure like that's exactly the same, or like the well thing where it's like that weird cavern to that like glowy well area we fought the goat people.
The glowy well area.
Or that stupid house where we were like,
come meet me by the glowy well area.
In the bug cave, that thing we like got destroyed on also in our first playthrough.
That's right. Yeah.
The bugs. Oh my God.
Ooh.
Holy crap. Yeah, that was a tough one.
What are you going to do?
Quite destroyed on that one. But we have those
In our short few weeks of recent play, we have a few tales to tell about total. I mean, our ass is getting kicked to the moon.
Yeah. I did put the first one up. I was able to edit it so like both our cameras were actually on screen, kind of like now, only in the corners. So it like, and like I was switching back and forth between our camera views. So like that first video was up, and I'm gonna try and get the rest up in the next.
Would you put that on YouTube?
Yeah, on YouTube. Yep. I think it actually today's the was it 23rd?
Yes,
so,
sir.
On the date of this recording, so that's up now, and hopefully there'll be a few more on top of that.
Yeah, and hopefully the next time you hear from us, we'll be playing the resurrected Diablo 2.
Yeah, that would be nice. I mean, at the very least, we're definitely going to be doing a Diablo, probably a really big Diablo 2. In general, podcast, I think, is
Definitely prior to release of the new one
that we want to bring on. And I think we'll just try to record,
share some good stories
with put them all together, because we just this Diablo 2 especially was a lot of people coming together, and we definitely want to like go through that again. I feel like,
oh, yeah, man, we had a blast back in the day just getting together in these games, this StarCraft, a few others, UO.
True,
and we poured, you know, as a young man would, hours and hours of lifetime into these games.
but it was sort of like hanging out with your friends more than anything else.
Yeah. And this was even like, it's funny because like now I feel like the amount of options with like chat, like between like Discord.
Oh,
like
yeah. PlayStation chat, so much better.
We didn't have that. We just
it
had
was all type chat. Yeah.
Yeah. Or maybe we would have been on the phone talking while we were playing for a little bit. But it
and that
like
wasn't a cell phone either. That was a hard telephone line. Yeah.
Not too much of those, but like,
oh,
I'm sure
man. The good old days.
Yeah. Oh, man.
These kids will never know. What do you mean? You had a phone attached to a wire with a head? What? Like, yeah. Oh, and we used to hold it up to our ears like this. And it was huge. Remember, like, that in 80s and 90s movies had, like, how big the first cell phones were?
I mean,
it's
I
like the big radio, you know, pieces that they had in the military.
Zach Morris, Saved by the Bell.
Oh, my God.
That was it. That was the phone, pretty much. I've seen that phone when that first came out. I knew a few, like, of my parents' friends, like, had it. And it was like, oh, that's
and all ridiculous. The imported cars had Le Car phones in them.
Yeah, the car phone.
Remember those
oh
things?
God.
Yeah.
Holy crap. How do you,
those were the first cell phone.
Yeah, like, you rent a car, and it's like, there's a phone in here?
Uh-huh.
What do you mean?
Pretty cool, actually.
High class, huh?
That was, like, the original cell phone, I guess, really.
Yeah.
Car phones.
Yeah. Back in the day, you like needed to leave the house with change in case you needed to use a payphone.
Call collect.
Which, I mean, I don't even think you had that option in those days.
Charge it to your buddy's mom.
Yeah.
Remember, sorry.
Like,
I had no quarter.
And all the 1-800 collect commercials and all that stuff.
Yeah, and Dime. Remember that? 10 cents per call or whatever they would promo.
Insane.
Yeah. Woo. Going back in time.
Talking about technology killing other like technology.
Cell phones.
Yeah,
yeah.
Going back in time. Holy smokes, man.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did you have a favorite aspect of Diablo that
a favorite aspect of Diablo? I enjoyed the. It was a unique story, right?
Hmm.
Yes, it was a, you know, basically a biblical type of story, but it's they made it their own.
Yeah.
And I tend to like video games that are narrative driven in general.
Sure.
If they tell a good story, for me, that type of stuff usually tends to hold the test of time more than anything else in particular. So I think I felt totally comfortable playing the version we just played where it was like, you know, 1080p style.
Right. I mean, right. And we had already played through it, so it's not like we're ruining anything for ourselves. Like, we went through it. Like,
oh, yeah, for sure.
Forgive us as an old man. We have come to grow, you know, accustomed to certain comforts.
Yeah, you get spoiled.
Yep.
In our old age.
Yep. So,
no, let's not push it.
I will say, which granted we can't do in this one, they took it out, but in the original I was a master duper duplicating
master duper.
I got so good at doing
write that one out. Down kids master
yep.
duper
master dupes between John and I especially had like a bunch like where you'd be holding on to because we both had our mage characters, so you'd be holding on to books that you needed to like work your magic up to read, but it would benefit us to each have books for the other person. And the idea was if you weren't aware, your number buttons 1 through I think it was like 8 or 9 were your potions. So the idea was that you would have your character drop an item like on a screen somewhere.
That would be the hotkey.
You would have potions on your belt ready to go. You walk above the item, you go to click the item, so your character would be walking towards the item to pick it up. And the idea is that as you get to it and your character's picking it up, you also left click on a potion in your on your belt to pull it up. And what it does is the item will appear in your inventory. And then when you drop the potion that you just picked up on the floor, the item duplicates on the floor.
Dude, we used to think we were so cool for doing stuff like this back in the day. You would go to like, regardless of the game, if there was like a so-called exploit to the game where you can manipulate something within the game, especially the online multiplayer games, because it's like, you know, you're not just messing with the computer, you're messing with other people who are already playing live.
So any type of these exploits or hacks or anything to that degree, like, was that not like the coolest thing back in the day? Like, we thought we were hot shit, you know? Like, oh, check this out, man. I can duplicate gold in Diablo. Can you do that? No, because you suck.
Yeah, you don't know what you're doing. I'll do for you. Don't
you're
worry.
Trash. I'll dupe it. Watch.
I'll take care of you.
Gold.
I'm so awesome.
Gold. I poop gold.
The, what do you call it? The one thing that used to be funny with that, though, is especially with, like, the wizard, you'd get, like, a ring, and, like, finding the same ring was, like, crazy. Like, I would never have it. So, like, I would just duplicate the ring, but then I'd get killed. And because all your stuff drops on the floor, if you drop the original item and the duplicated item on the ground at the same time, all the extras delete themselves. Like, it says, like, duplicate found, deleting.
Yeah.
So you'd be left with the one. So I'd have to redupe my own stuff. Oh. Kind of making it a problem for yourself. But, yeah,
so
that's
stressful.
The suck and die.
But well, you shouldn't be doing it anyway. So yeah,
the spell books are huge because you can't just buy whatever spell you want. You either had to hope Adria had it for, like, whatever crazy money she was selling it for, or you found these stupid bookshelves in the game that would drop a random book, and you hope it's the one you need, and you hope you have enough magic to have it, and then you read the book, and it's gone. So you dupe a few of these until you, like, reach the level you're at, and then that would be the process. It was great.
There you go. Cheat to win, baby.
Dude, it took forever to do it otherwise.
That's the message, like, to the kids. Cheat to win.
I mean, it's barely cheating. You're not, like,
manipulate item, your environment to win.
The items and money and stuff, sure, but, like, the spell books, like, the alternative is you just keep going into the dungeon randomly looking for bookshelf. Like, it's just, it's ridiculous. It's a time waster. When all you want to do is just, you've already leveled up to have the spell. Just, you know, just have it.
Time waster.
I justified that very much.
Hey, man.
Other people be like, you dirty duping bastard. How could you?
You do you.
You are ruining what this game is supposed to be about. Yep.
Whatever, it's funny. Man. I always find that so funny when people get very precious and sensitive about, you know, video game stuff. Mm-hmm. To me, it's hilarious. Listen, video games, obviously, we do a podcast about video games. It means a lot to us.
Sure,
but
does.
To be precious about the honor, you know, I guess when it's more multiplayer and someone else loses out on something, it sort of kills the fun. But if you're playing a game and you're duping gold to get better items just so you survive these ridiculous dungeons,
right,
not the end of the world, but everyone's a different judge on those things.
With, like stupid elite items, like, that's what ended up killing Diablo 2 was the single player part. We used to, like, hold our own save files.
Yeah.
You had to go on Battle.net because the people would just come into, like, PvP on the single player multiplayer option, and they'd have, like, these ridiculous items that would, like, one shot you, and it's like, all right, this isn't even fun. Like, you're
right,
like,
it gets
crying.
Stupid.
You're being stupid now. Like, why'd you do this? You just think it's fun to, like, kill people with your, you know, like, I could have a hacked item and murder you real quick too. Like, that's dumb.
If there's a game where it's online and multiplayer and you can be griefed in some way, there's always going to be the griefer type people because it's entertaining to people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I got them.
Don't get me wrong. Sometimes that's hilarious.
That's what I mean.
That's
you see?
The reason why people do it is sometimes it's hilarious.
Cheat to win.
It's really not when it's yourself, but when you're cheating to, like, get stupid easy, like, that's stupid. Like, it's one thing.
I love how we're gatekeeping different types of cheating now. This
really
cheating is okay because
I
think it's
like
fun.
Rather,
this other cheating. Not
when
kosher.
Someone's just good at the game and, like, gets you, and it's like, oh, and you just feel, like, terrible. It's like, yeah, because you do suck a little. Like, it hurts you. It hurts you deep here. But, like, when you're getting, like, you know,
that's the stress. I suck.
You're like, all right, I don't even have a chance right now. Hey. This isn't even like you're good at this. You're just lucky you have this stupid nonsense at the win.
Exploits, man. Video game exploits.
Yeah. But at the same time, when you're able to step back, it's still funny.
Yeah.
How angry you got.
Well, that's the idea of games, right? As long as you're having a good time.
Mm.
That's what it's all about.
Yep. And we were definitely enjoying ourselves with this Diablo 1. And that's it, man. We're ready for Resurrected.
Yeah.
That's what we're saying. I'm sure
to say the least.
Well.
So what's the next step? If we were to go back and play Diablo, where are we going? There's no quest, right? So it's just infinite dungeons?
There's an end point. It's Diablo. That's it. Like, we're working way to eventually the door where Diablo will come out.
Oh, you will work? Okay.
Uh-huh. Yep. Normally, you'd fight, I think, like...
to Hell's Gate.
You might run into Lazarus. I think he still exists, but... like, remember we found that, like... oh, man. Remember we had that one weird glitchy thing where that, like, random sorcerer dude was in that room, and then he, like...
he vanished in... yeah, he teleported into the wall.
But he wasn't really in the wall, because you were kind of, like, seeing him, but he just... we almost killed him. And then
Yeah, unfortunately, he was... it was as if he was in the wall.
Yeah.
So we couldn't hit him, he couldn't hit us, and we just moved on.
I don't remember what... I'm pretty sure it's a quest thing where it's, like, just some guy that, like... he was like, he kept doing, like, firewall and stuff like that. It was horrible. No, it wasn't firewall. He was doing, like, Nova or something, like, crazy stuff. Because the firewall guy is the one that you get that cool armor from with the whole blood stone nonsense. This was, like, before that. He was just, like, in the cathedral things, and he was just a mage, like, whooping our ass.
Hey. Sometimes you give an ass whooping, and sometimes you take an ass whooping.
Dude, go get him. And then he just, like, was gone. It was like, we didn't kill him. Where is he? And then he just was, like, standing there, just like, you guys don't see me, right?
Uh-oh.
No one here but us.
Either way, we're excited about Diablo 2 Resurrected. I'm sure you all are, too, if you're tuning into this podcast.
Hopefully, we might be able to get a shot to get into the beta when that comes out. We did not have luck with the
alpha. I hope so. We'll let you know.
Yeah.
We'll let you know.
Anyone that has, I hope you got to enjoy it. Feel free to let us know what your experiences were. Let us know if you also got into Diablo and, you know, want to. Again, whether you're watching this on YouTube or just listening it wherever you're getting your podcast from, you know, we appreciate you listening in. But, you know, reach out to us. Let us know. We don't have the website anymore. We kind of did away with that. We weren't really keeping up with it, and it's not worth it. We'd rather keep ourselves on.
I mean, we're in the modern age now where people can find our podcast on all their favorite podcasting apps. And also on YouTube, if you want to watch our funny-looking faces, find us on YouTube on the VG Boys channel. And we update this simultaneously as the audio on all the streaming platforms.
Yep,
so
on Twitter, VG Boys has its own account that we've been using. We also have our own individual ones, and the Instagram also VG Boys. Adam likes to throw up some nice gaming related stuff on there.
Yeah, man. We have fun.
Yeah, man. As you should. As we all should. As I hope you are.
That's what it's all about, man. This is going to be a good summer. We're going to play some good games. We're going to talk some good games. Yep. And most of all, really, don't be jealous, baby.
Catch you on the next one. Are you just jealous? 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 Because we're the VG Boys. Yeah. Are you just jealous? 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 Because we're the VG Boys.
Peace.